We're heading into week 8 of the Major League Lacrosse season, and the Denver Outlaws are 4-2, which puts them in second place in the league. I'm Jenny Fusillo, talking with MLL analyst Ron Zwerin. Ron, they're facing off against Ohio on Friday night. Now, they beat Ohio in week 2, but Ohio has come back and is now in third place in the league. What's it going to take for them to beat Ohio in week 8?
Well, I think that Denver needs to do what they do best, and offensively that means be dynamic, share the ball, get a lot of assisted goals, or what I like to call team goals. When Denver plays team lacrosse, they're a very, very, very difficult matchup. I think defensively, the one thing that Denver needs to be aware of is that when you start looking at some of the players for the machine, they can shoot from range, from outside in the two-point arc. So Denver defensively is going to have to be mindful of where Kyle Harrison is at all times, and they'll also have to be mindful of where the attack are moving from when they're going side to side or when they're getting from goal line extended, because a lot of those guys that are cutting in could certainly cause Denver defensively a lot of trouble.
Now, this week, Wesberg is making his debut for the Outlaws, and John Grant Jr. has been back for a couple weeks, and the roster's kind of taking full form. What does it mean to have them all together?
Well, we'll see. You know, we'll see what it looks like. I mean, Wesberg, what a whirlwind week for this guy. I mean, now, today, he's in Washington, D.C., for the Tuaratawn Award ceremony that takes place this week, and then he's going to fly back to Denver for the game just on Monday. He was winning a national championship, so he might be a little bit gassed, and that might be acceptable, expected, rather. But I think that to have all of these players back in is going to really help Denver get back to that Denver Outlaws style of lacrosse, that up-and-down, high-speed, high-octane lacrosse. And I really think that having Wesberg on this team is a long-term perfect fit because, let's face it, John Grant Jr., he can't play forever, even though it looks like he probably can. He cannot play forever, and I think that Wesberg, whether we have seen him play in MLL or not, I think that long-term, he will be the succession plan for John Grant Jr. because I think he's that good, and I think he's going to translate that well to Major League Lacrosse.
Now, last year, Denver Outlaws, they were the MLL champs, and then this year, Denver took the NCAA title. You've been calling games there for quite a while now. Talk about the growth of the sport in Denver.
You know, it's been phenomenal to see how the sport has taken off here since the 80s. You know, we've always had wonderful athletes coming from Colorado, going to the East Coast and playing at a high level. Players who are now in the Colorado Lacrosse Hall of Fame, like Christian Cook, who went to play in Princeton and won a championship with Bill Tierney. A number of players have come from the state to go on and play on the East Coast. But now what you're seeing is a lot of high schools are now using lacrosse as a sanctioned sport, and there are over 100 schools across the state that are playing sanctioned lacrosse. So the game is growing by leaps and bounds. The youth fields are filled every single Saturday and every single Sunday, and the talent is now coming from Colorado. And I think that you know, you listen to what Bill Tierney said in a couple of interviews after winning the national championship, that Denver should be a blueprint for how other states that are west of the Mississippi can actually start growing lacrosse programs and start growing the sport even more. And so to see it grow so rapidly here in Colorado in the last 10 years has certainly been a treat for me growing up here my entire life.
Thanks, Ron. That's MLL analyst Ron Zwerin. Tune into ESPN3 Friday night at 7 p.m. to see the Denver Outlaws take on the Ohio Machine.